Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Sunday, SpaceX launched the USSF-67 mission on a Falcon Heavy rocket.
One, engine full power, and lift off of USSF-67. Go Falcon Heavy, go Space Force.
The two boosters which launched this mission, B-1064 and B-1065, landed for the second time each on the landing pads at LZ-1 and LZ-2.
Sidecore entry burn startup.
And there you can see on your screen, the entry burns for these side boosters have begun. They're just about 12 seconds long.
PY-FTS has saved and NY-FTS has saved.
And the entry burns for both side boosters have now concluded. Now, next up will be the final burn for each of these side boosters. That is the landing burn. It is just a single engine burn, the center E9 engine. Each one of these M1D engines have about 190,000 pounds of thrust. So that is enough to slow the vehicle down just in time for landing. And you could see the coast of Florida in the background.
Side boosters are transonic.
Now that landing burn coming up here in just about 20 seconds or so. Landing burn will last about 20 seconds long. Again, we are scheduled to land on landing zone 1 and landing zone 2.
Landing burn.
And there are those landing burns have begun on the side boosters. So let's watch as they touch down.
Stage 2 is on thermal guidance. Stage 2 FTS is saved.
Booster landing leg deployed.
Incredible sight to see as we watch the side boosters touch down for landing. That confirms successful landing of both Falcon Heavy side boosters on landing zone 1 and landing zone 2. Now with these two side boosters, this marks the 163rd and 164th overall successful landing of an orbital class rocket.
In addition to that launch, earlier today SpaceX launched the GPS-3-6 mission on a Falcon 9 rocket. The booster which launched this mission, B-1077, then landed successfully for the second time on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas.
Let's see if we stick the landing with the first stage.
Landing leg deploy. Stage one landing confirmed.
All right, there we heard the call out that we have that stage one landing confirmed.
Expected loss of signal, keep.
The next launch should hopefully be a Starlink mission. The delayed Starlink 4-2 mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 19th at 1:23 p.m. UTC or 8:23 a.m. EST. Heading to Boca Chica, here's Starship sitting on the orbital launch mount. SpaceX had a bit of a mishap as the front gate to the launch site fell over. This Starlink dispenser was seen being installed in a barrel section. The old Ship 22 prototype was moved to the high bay. As we saw last video, Starship 25 was recently rolled out to the launch site. Ship 25 was lifted onto the Pad B test mount. Also, as we saw last video, SpaceX did some full stack cryogenic testing of Starship. Taking a look at the road and beach closures, the possible closure for yesterday was cancelled. However, they have possible closures for today, Wednesday 18th, tomorrow, Thursday 19th and Friday 20th this week. Then next week they have possible closures for Monday 23rd and Tuesday 24th. As I record this video, the road and beach are closed and there is full stack testing of Starship underway. I believe today they are doing a full stack wet dress rehearsal of Starship. Here's a view of Booster 10's methane section in the mid-bay. As always, I have to say thanks to Nick Antsuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.